You know, over the last 10 years or so, we've seen people who, like DJs, like poets, people, performance artists, people from completely outside rock music who've come into rock music and made good work in there. And I think that's what rock music has always been about. It's always been a medium that existed to absorb lots of other strange things and to bind them together into some kind of music. It's very... It's a very eclectic and generous art form in that way, as opposed to classical music, which is very focused and very ungenerous, in fact, in its intake of people.
Is your rapport with lyrics and literature in general gone further enough to consider a writer to put your music to?
Yeah, if I ever found such a person.
You haven't found a writer?
No, I've been thinking about this. But the kind of language I find myself liking is not really literary language. For instance, I lately have been recording a lot of... purely informational broadcasts on the radio, like weather forecasts and stocks and share prices and so on. And this, to me, is very musical. Just lists of things, people reading lists and numbers. That I like that, and I like it because it doesn't have personality, and it doesn't have literary meaning. I just don't, again, another thing I don't want to be involved in is the world of psychoanalysis. All this sort of thing about what does it mean, who is it talking, and all that kind of thing. I think that's just all old-fashioned too. I don't like it.
What does it feel like?
Well, psychoanalysis was the religion of the 20th century, and it's a dead religion now, I think.
We'll see Woody Allen.
Exactly, a good example of a dead priest.
Just a brief explanation of the high technology park that you probably will be creating with Peter Gabriel and Laurie Anderson in Barcelona.
Well, it might not be high technology. Depends on the budget. It might be very low technology.
But is there any plan of production times? Can you say, come to the Barcelona park by 1994?
That's probably exactly right, 1994. What
will it be interactive? Can people go there
yes,
and use the...
Yes, but the big struggle we're having at the moment is with money. Not the money to build it, but the money that you have to pay to get in. You see, I really want it to be either cheap or free, so that people who live there can go in a lot of times and can learn to become skillful on the things in there. A lot of the things we want to make are interactive, and therefore they demand certain, or they encourage certain levels of skill. Well, you can never develop that if you can only afford to go there once a year. So I want it to be very cheap or free, just like a park, but a park with some special things in. This is a real problem financially, but I'm sure something will happen soon.
Mm-hmm.
We haven't got final permission yet from Barcelona. we think we're sure we'll get it actually, but it's not final yet, so we don't have a starting date. Best audiences go to rock shows. Mm. Those are the people who are alive. I just hate being in things where I have to sit there like this, you know. I hate being in a music that is so designed to exclude me from it. And classical music, unfortunately, has developed to be like that. It wasn't like that once. You know, there was a time when classical music was very interactive, when people made a lot of noise, when they got excited about it, and they showed their excitement. And it's like that still in classical Indian music. If you go to a classical Indian concert, people applaud during the music and stand up and shout and tap their feet and everything. But what's happened to Western classical music is that the walls around it, separating it from the audience, have got thicker and thicker. Mm-hmm. And I just don't like that. I don't want to be part of that.